ESPN Sunday on ESPN Classic.
Here in Texas, they call him 41. We call him Mr. President. George Bush addressing the troops as they salute the former president, and the Aggies of Texas A&M getting ready to address the number two team in the country. Under R.C. Slocum in 14 years, they've won 86% of their games here at Kyle Field. They hope that they can improve that percentage today, but what a task at hand they have. The number two ranked team in the country, the number one ranked team in the BCS poll, the Oklahoma Sooners, one of the remaining undefeateds in here at Kyle Field, the home of the 12th man. Sunny and windy. It might raise a little bit of havoc with some punts today, as well as some field goals. So we'll keep an eye on that.
And also the return guys trying to catch that football.
Exactly.
Going to be very difficult.
Bob Stoops, as Bob and I talked about, he says there's something about this team that reminds me of 2000. The same feelings there. He's never lost this year. And on the other side, R.C. Slocum, his record against Oklahoma and even 500. R.C.'s problem recently has been playing against top-ranked teams. They're 11-7 against ranked teams at home. And his team 5-4, having lost three on their home field. That almost never happens. They're usually about 6-0 here every year.
For sure. Three losses in 1 year, that takes care of about 10 years right here.
Trey DiCarlo to kick. Terrence Thomas, Bethel Johnson are back deep to receive. 5 yards deep, Bethel Johnson will take a knee. And the Aggies will work from their own 20-yard line with Dustin Long. We saw him earlier this year against Virginia Tech, although they used a lot of Reggie McNeal in that game. But since that game, that's when their offense changed.
And what it does not show on that profile is he's got some speed, 4'6", and he is very mobile, so he can get outside the pocket and throw the football on the run.
The problem he faces, now the guys in the white jerseys and the crimson helmets on the other side are as good a defense as you'll find any place, any time. Three wideouts to start the game. They give it off to Weber, and there's the defense I'm talking about. Immediate loss of five, courtesy Tommy Harris. Our Nivea for men starting lineups. Here's the big fellas up front for the Aggies. Hightower, Yates, Hangartner, Whitley, and Alan Ruber in there today as a starter at right tackle for Andre Brooks, who's had a virus. Joe Weber starts in place of Derek Farmer. As I mentioned, they lose their starting tailback, Joseph. Porter's a tight end. Johnson and Thomas are wide receivers. And there's Joe, who lost four on his first carry. So back up to the 16-yard line. Second and 14. Long. It is almost intercepted. And it was Lance Mitchell, the rangy middle linebacker, that got back there to break it up. Here's the defense that we're talking about. You've already seen what Tommy Harris can do, raise havoc in a backfield with Wilkerson, Klein, and Jackson. The linebackers, Teddy Lehman's on the butt-kiss list. Mitchell's the leading tackler. Pasha Jackson, another junior college transfer. In the secondary, doesn't come much better than this group. Wolfolk, Everidge, who's been all over the field lately. Bassey and Derek Straighten on the other corner. And there's Mitchell, who leads the team in tackles.
And they're second in the nation in turnover margin with a plus 14. So they're looking to intercept every time you throw the football.
They got a three-man rush here unless they blitz, and they may have jumped offside. Harris, I think, hit the center.
Got defense.
And it is a defensive penalty, and they'll walk off five against the Sooners. Make it a little bit easier. Still going to be third down and long.
Offside on the defense, five-yard penalty, still third down.
Al Dodden, our referee, and so Tommy Harris has taken almost five away, and then he gave five back right there with a penalty.
Makes it a little bit easier. Third and nine is a lot easier than third and 14.
So as they break the huddle, Porter goes out in a slot to the top of your screen. Two wideouts there with him, 40% on the year. On third down conversions for the Aggies. Long all day to throw. Deep middle, there it is. And it's Porter on the run. And he's out to the 45-yard line, first down. He's the main man, a career high last week, 154 yards through the air, and he just ripped off a 24-yard reception there.
That's the game plan. That's the game plan, is to get the inside man, Porter, number 44, just to the inside of where I drew, in the center of the field. He's a 6'5", 230-pound wide receiver slash tight end. He's a baseball player in the minor leagues. He has the best hands on the team. Big portion of the game plan right there today.
Those were his catches coming in. 39 now in the year. That's tops for any tight end in college football at this point. Now they go back to the ground game, and Weber spins his way for four.
That first down they just picked up was a big pass for Dustin Long and a big first down to keep the momentum and keep the ball field position. If you don't do anything worse on the rest of this drive, at least just punt it away.
They're already out near midfield at the 49-yard line. They stay with the three wide receivers set as Long looks over to the sideline, gets the call sent in by former starting quarterback Mark Ferris. There's the ranking, only 90th in the country in rushing, but uncharacteristically, as Bob said, way up there in the passing department. And he'll pass again, down the middle again, in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, Bethel Johnson. Johnson comes in as, right now, their number one man all time in reception yardage, I should say, in a career for Texas A&M. 1,592 career receiving yards.
Favorite class is ballet.
That was Swanee's, too, see?
Yeah, I know. He and Swanee are just probably Swanee could teach him a few things about ballet, I guess.
Some of those demi-plays or whatever you call them.
Agility and poise.
There you go. And wisdom. Long to throw. And incomplete on third down. And so, as Bob said, if nothing else, it changes a bit the field position because they're going to have to kick it away.
Well, Oklahoma defensively said, hey, Dustin, you're not going to sit back there and pick us apart. They blitzed, the little zone blitz. They had more rushers than had blockers, and he just got rid of them.
Cody Skates, second in the conference in punting. He's a good one. And he hangs one high in the air. Fair catch by Perkins, who lets it go, and the Aggies are going to have a play on it at the three-yard line. Byron Jones will start in the secondary today on the special team. Downs a 48-yard punt at the three.
Well, first of all, Yates is kicking into a pretty good win, as we mentioned at the opening. So the ball came straight down, and Jones was there.
Remember that guy who used to be called Wild Thing? The guy who wanted to spend the entire honeymoon indoors? Remember the one who couldn't resist a little mischief? Yeah, that guy. He's back. Viagra. Not all medications are for everyone. Ask your doctor if Viagra is right for you.
For the past 2 years, my mom has been the team mom. She likes to knit. A lot. She watches very closely what we eat.
Boys, what is this?
And of course, she makes sure we eat our Campbell's chunky soup, like new savory beef pot roast.
How about those big chunks of beef and veggies?
Our team's a family, and she's the mom.
Campbell's Chunky, it fills you up right.
There's a power so awesome, so irresistible, you'll do anything to get your hands on it. Introducing Gillette M3 Power. Turn on the first battery-powered shaving system from Gillette and turn on the amazing new Power Glide blades. Micropulses raise the hair, so you shave closer in one power stroke. Feel the power of the world's best shave. For maximum power, change the battery every 6 months. New M3 Power from Gillette.
F-16. Hornet. F-111.
The Acura RSX Type S, now with 210 horsepower. You'll know it when you hear it.
Richard Jefferson's birthday.
John.
June 21st.
Correct.
Elton Brand's favorite restaurant.
Crystal Bay, Peekskill, New York.
That'll be Crystal Bay, Peekskill, New York.
That's right, Tim. Hey, Elton, you got to buzz in.
NBA Shootaround, the pregame show with all the answers, Friday, 7:30 p.m. on ESPN.
Every Wednesday night, ESPN Classic, get your Irish up.
We're going to get them on an under.
Go! Every Wednesday night, ESPN Classic has a golden dome.
Here we go!
Every Wednesday night, there's only one place to find the Fighting Irish.
Touchdown, Notre Dame!
with the dominant players, the legendary games, and the inside stories, you'll have a better seat than the band. Classic Notre Dame, 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 Central, Wednesdays on ESPN Classic.
Saturday on ESPN Classic. At 8, it's Sports Century Chuck Bednarik. At 9 and 9:30, a double dose of classics hit comedy Cheap Seats. Then at 10, a Colts-Dolphins showdown from 71. Tonight on ESPN Classic.
Brad Davis, they finally got him to the sideline. When we talked to offensive line coach and running game coordinator Kevin Wilson this week, we said, who's playing great on your offensive line? He said, Brad Davis is our man, and there's the man right there. You can see getting rolled up on from behind, hit on top, his right knee is the problem. And
sometimes those are a lot worse than they look.
That's a main cog in that offensive line for the Sooners. And they have stayed healthy with the exception of losing Jason White, their quarterback, pretty much all year. Nate Hybl has been the man the whole year because of that one. Here's Quentin Griffin inside. And Bob, we talked, you and Swan and I talked with Bob Stoops about that very fact. In the year 2000, when they won the national title, they stayed healthy. And up until right now.
Exactly.
You know,
we mentioned that to Bob the other day, and we didn't mention Jason White. And he said, well, you decided from Jason White, which was a big loss at the time. But the way Nate Hybl has come on and played, they've almost made him forget about Jason White. He's with the team and all that, but he was a important part. But until this injury here, almost all of the starters have started every game.
34 out of 40 in the red zone. You saw the percentage. Kewan Jones in there. He gets the call. He's a guy that knows how to smell the end zone, but he's not even going to sniff the five-yard line here. Boy, on short yardage, the Aggies have come to play. And it's Ty Warren again, number 94.
Well, Bob and Brad, in the red zone, Oklahoma, of those 34 scores, only eight have been by the air. And I talked to Chuck Long before the game, and he said, of those eight, probably five or six of them only come on third down. So throwing in the red zone is not their first choice.
They've got three wideouts, and Trent Schmidt, the tight end's in a slot. He's one of Hybl's favorite receivers. On third and goal, out in the flat, Quentin Griffin on the run, touchdown, Oklahoma. Just got in the corner, a six-yard touchdown.
Nicely done.
For Quentin Griffin, receiving this year, that's his second touchdown reception. His eighth touchdown of the year, the 40th of his career. So the Sooner fans that have made the seven-hour trek to College Station are happy. Trey DiCarlo, the freshman kicker, in for the point after. Right down the middle. So, again, remember, that all started with an interception by Perkins. They take it down the field, and on third and goal, tuck it in the corner. 7-0 Sooners.
In the mood for something grilled? Stouffer's makes it easy with their succulent new grilled chicken entrees. A grilled herb-rubbed chicken breast seared over an open flame to seal in its juices and served with tender linguine and a medley of crisp vegetables tossed in a light tomato herb sauce. As for your grill, put it on ice. Stouffer's new grilled herb chicken, one of four new grilled chicken entrees from Stouffer's.
Sunday on ESPN Classic. All she wants is to coach football.
Now what do you say?
Why don't you quit so we can get us a real coach?
But is she tough enough? Is she man enough to turn these losers...
Do you want to play football?
Yeah.
...into winners? Wesley Snipes, Woody Harrelson, and Goldie Hawn. Wildcats. On Real Classics, where the worlds of sports and movies collide. 8 p.m. Sunday on ESPN Classic.
The average American household has nearly $8,000 in credit card debt. If you make only the minimum payments and have high interest rates, it could take you 47 years to pay them off. That's a scary thought. You can stop living in fear and get help. Call InCharge Debt Solutions. InCharge is a nonprofit credit counseling service. Our trained and certified counselors can discuss your options to get you out of debt and put you back in charge of your life. We work with creditors nationwide to reduce your interest rates and lower your monthly payments, helping you pay off your debt faster and more affordably than you could on your own. In Charge can stop the collection calls and design a solution that's right for you. Stop living in fear. Call today to get back in charge of your life.
Third down and 11.
Hey, he had a movie contract.
Hybl to throw. Deep middle. Got him on the fly across the 40. And it's Will Peoples. And Kiel makes the tackle, but it's a pickup of 24.
Peoples is their leading receiver. Going to get to the middle of the field. He's out here on this side. Watch as he's going to come to the center of the field. They got him spread from the top of the screen to the bottom. Now right there in the middle, the one receiver clears out. He's clearing out, and this receiver comes right into the open area.
Hybl from the gun now, first down. Here's a little option for the first time today, and Nate will keep it. And he got to about the 45-yard line. Hibble's not a bad runner, and that's more of the offense that we probably would have seen had Jason White not gotten hurt earlier in the season.
White, a much better runner than and very much more mobile than Nate, but that's not to say Nate can't run it.
Right.
And it's good that they throw that in, because it drives defensive coordinators mad to have to prepare for the option.
Penwright, who was part of the tackle and is one of the leading players on this defense, still face down for A&M. They can ill afford to lose him. Home of the 12th man, Kyle Field. You always got to be ready if called on. Second down and 8. Quentin Griffin broke free on his way. Down the sideline, out of bounds at the 35. And he slips down. As soon as you get off that field, there's that cement around the field, and Hybl's already hit the deck today. And Q goes down after a gain of 20.
Not many running backs in college football could have made this move. Little draw play. He starts, goes all the way over the center and says, hey, no, that's no good. I sucked them all in there. Now I'm going to go all the way around the end.
I sure think he's got a little Barry Sanders in him, don't you?
I do, well, for sure. And what he has is quick feet and great vision.
And already 76 yards on the ground. First down at the 35. Hybl again in the spread. Plenty of time to throw deep down the middle. Got his man on the run, Trent Smith. And it is first and goal, Oklahoma.
Trent Smith is the tight end, was lined up at a wide receiver. He's 6'5", and just gets down the seam. There's a good shot of what Nate's looking at. Now, you don't look at your receiver. You look at the defensive backs. You know where the receiver is going to be. You just want to make sure that you throw it to the open area where he is going to get.
Trent's become a better blocker this year and a more complete tight end, but he can really stretch the field. Kewan Jones now on first down. Might have gotten 2 down to the 5.
That's a big-time throw.
And it should be no surprise, Brad and Bob, to fans of football, that Oklahoma has to throw the ball on first down early, have to come up with some misdirection plays, because this Texas A&M defense is too good against a run. You cannot make a living just running the ball at them. So don't be surprised if Oklahoma doesn't come out here and elect to throw the ball on second down as opposed to waiting to third.
You're right, Swanee. That comes directly from the coaching staff. This is a very bright, aware staff. They do what they have to do.
Eighth play of the drive, toss to Kewan Jones, and he is just smothered. And again, Randall Webb and Keelan Jackson, and that's exactly what Swanee was talking about. They have found the running game to be hard for Oklahoma against this Aggie defense in those kind of situations.
And both of these guys are backups. Due to injuries, they're in the mix. But Webb, number 55, runs through right there. And Jackson is playing, as we said, for Appel, the free safety, who's out with an injury.
Key numbers for Nate Hybl, the number 3. On third down, he's 3 for 3, 3 first downs, 3 different receivers.
I like that.
Now it's third and goal. Got a bunch of receivers, 3 of them to the right. He goes that way, complete, but immediately hit was Lance Donnelly, the tight end, and Oklahoma's going to have to settle for a field goal attempt.
That's good defense. That's just good defense. Knowing, being aware, they have 3 receivers bunched to the right. 2 of them crossed left. 1 of them hanging out to the right. Good coverage.
Trey DiCarlo will come in to attempt a 25-yard field goal. Remember, 2 years ago here, Oklahoma ran a fake field goal in a very similar situation and scored a touchdown.
You seemed to have a pretty good win.
DiCarlo from 25. And it's up and good. So Oklahoma tacks three more on, but the Aggie defense stiffened when it had to. 10-0.
Looks like the usual flurry of activity. Have you seen Mr. Goodwrench? Hello?
I can't work under these conditions.
Well, have you learned anything?
They're all using genuine GM parts and they're all experts, but I can't tell one from the other.
That's it? I thought you said you were in the service.
I said I was in the service industry. I'm an aromatherapist.
Time for Plan B.
Find Mr. Goodwrench at all GM dealerships nationwide.
All right, on to Plan C.
What'd you have for dinner?
Pound and a half of barbecued chicken, boneless pork ribs, mashed potatoes. You?
Piece of quiche, sprouts, and a side salad.
Blow out the candles. Whoa!
Quiche.
Should've had a Hungry Man XXL, an extra large portion of the food men love. Hungry Man XXL, it's good to be full.
I'm sorry, I was driving too fast.
No, really, totally my fault.
The good thing is we're okay.
There's so many more important things in life.
If I'm not mistaken, you must be gelling.
Like Magellan.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are made from the softest gel ever created. If you and your shoes don't feel outrageously comfortable, you get your money back. Guaranteed.
Come on, move it!
Listen to that yelling.
He's so not gelling.
Are you gelling? Dr. Scholl's.
Joe Paterno is a living legend, maybe the greatest college coach ever.
Come back in the huddle!
So, would you be surprised to hear him say this?
But I can't get excited about losing a football game. We lose.
60 Minutes on Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesday on ESPN Classic.
His search for perfection.
He's consumed by preparation.
But can he win the big one?
I don't want to be in year 15 or 16 saying, I hope we win a Super Bowl.
Sports Century, Peyton Manning, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central, Monday on ESPN Classic.
Oklahoma up 10-0 on the Aggies here at Kyle Field. And DiCarlo set to kick. Terrence Thomas and Jason Carter waiting on the other end. They're camped at about the 10-yard line expecting a short kick. They have to backpedal a couple of steps to take it. Terrence Thomas from the 6. And he was met head-on before he got to the 20.
Peoples.
Will Peoples on the stop. Monday night, Al Michaels and John Madden going to bring out the Yellow Blazers even for this one. Monday Night Football's historic 500 telecast. They've got the league's most intense rivalry, and they'll reveal the game you selected as the greatest in Monday Night Football history so far, anyway. Raiders-Broncos, Monday night at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific. And there is one young Brian Greasy, 4-1 all-time against Oakland. And here's his daddy.
Hey, all right.
How about that?
I was talking to Brian the other night.
That was a Monday night game.
Yeah, it was.
One of your many touchdown passes on Monday Night Football.
I got to tell you about what's playing the Raiders.
Okay. Here's a pass nowhere near the intended receiver, Keith Joseph.
You know, we've got a graphic we're looking at here, but, you know, I played in the league for 15 years, and the first year I was out, I was broadcasting. I was down in Miami. What is this here?
He's second only to Johnny U, if the kid can keep it going.
Yeah.
That's good. Consecutive games with a touchdown pass.
Anyway, it was in the Orange Bowl. The Raiders were at the Dolphins. My first year out of football.
In broadcasting.
I was broadcasting. And the day before, we always go and watch the team work out. Well, the Raiders are there working out. And Al Davis sees me and comes over. And he says, hey, Bob, how you doing? And Brian was with me. He was 7 years old. And I talked to him last night. He says, yeah, I remember that.
Here's McNeal in trouble. Flushed out of the pocket's going to get a first down on the ground and then some. Out to about the 37-yard line. To go back, though, that's not the only thing Al Davis said to you other than, hi, Bob, how are you?
That's not the only thing he said. He says, but how you doing all this? He says, Bob, we were warming up, but when we start practicing, you got to leave. I said, you're kidding. He said, no, you got to leave.
Kicked you out of practice.
Brian remembers he kicked us out of practice. Now, this is Reggie McNeal playing is not because of Dustin Long, anything he did or didn't do. It just was kind of plan. They wanted to get him in the game and see if he can get something to do it and make the other team's defense prepare for his abilities.
At the 37-yard line, handoff. Weber, Joe on the inside. Nice run. And he got about seven out to the 44-yard line. Second down and three. Out of the spread, Reggie McNeal whistles. Take too much time.
I got the left tackle false start. False start, 75.
Fire the snap, false start, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Let's go, defense!
So the penalty goes against the Aggies and it forces second down and eight. Back at the 39-yard line.
Those plays are signaled in to Reggie. He looks down by number, looks down on his wristband for the corresponding play.
Here comes a blitz. McNeal loads and goes. Complete. Got a man on the run. Terrence Murphy. He's gone. Touchdown, Aggies. Yards, the longest play given up by the Oklahoma defense all year.
We mentioned the strength of this A&M offense was at wide receiver, and that's why they want to throw the ball more and get it out to the guys that can make some plays.
Todd Pegram in for the point after Porter to hold. Aggies right back in the football game. And the extra point is no good. He hit the right upright and missed it. So they got the touchdown, but they missed the extra points. And with 8:25 remaining in the half, the Aggies on the board. They trail 10-6.
What's cold? The frozen tundra, painted faces and flags. What's cold? Full blitzes, quarterbacks getting sacked. You see the air when they breathing? This is NFL season. What's the coldest tasting beer? Coors Light is freezing. No matter where you watch the game, we know you love cold beer. The frost is here, that hard-hitting time of the year. And we'll climb and we'll fight and claw our way to the finish. It's cold like that, and you could either watch it or live it.
Coors Light, the coldest tasting beer in the world.
To be absolutely sure I'm getting the lowest prices on electronics, I feel like I need a sign from above. That'll work.
I guess you're just what I need.
At Circuit City, you'll find unbeatable prices guaranteed. Save $280 on this feature-packed compact notebook computer. Just $749.99 after mail-in rebates, price break, and instant savings.
So what floor do you live on?
I live down the hall, 22B.
Are you the guy in the corner apartment?
Yeah.
You should really think about closing your blinds.
I'll keep that in mind.
Hey, we're moving!
Good thinking.
Pass Tostitos.
We should do this more often.
Yeah. Everyone loves a great crunchy taste of Tostitos scoops, and with a bite-sized bowl shape, you get the perfect dip every time.
So you see everything?
Yeah.
Right.
And now, look for our new blue bags.
You can handle a long, hard day, but can your deodorant? Yeah, it's Arm & Hammer Ultra Max with our clean feel formula for 24-hour protection. All day, all night. Guaranteed. Ultra Max deodorant. 24 hours of clean.
Now through Thursday, Zales is having a store-wide sale with savings throughout the entire store. Like this 5-carat diamond bracelet, just $4.99. Our lowest price ever. Quantities are limited. At Zales, the diamond store.
tricks.
Shitsu.
God bless you.
Cheap jokes.
What up, cold sore?
Ooh, that's nice.
Cheap women.
Yes!
That's my boyfriend for the week.
Sweet dress socks.
Cheap shots.
Of course I'm the king.
Oh, you're just the governor.
This is your job!
All right!
Cheap seats. 10 Eastern every Thursday night for a new look at the old games.
Kind of looks like a peacock that has to go to the bathroom.
Our Pacific Last game summary in the ballgame. Perkins' interception led to a 55-yard drive capped by that swing pass from Hybl to Quentin Griffin. And then the zip on the ball, Reggie McNeal. And on the run, Murphy for the touchdown. But they missed the extra point, hit the right upright, kissed it off the right upright, and that's where we are right now with the exception of DiCarlo's 25-yard field goal. 10-6, Oklahoma in front in a hard-hitting defensive battle is kind of what we expected to see, and that's what we've got. But Oklahoma's got a golden opportunity here. They don't want to waste it. And you know Bob Stoops, he wants seven. He doesn't want three.
Oh, on the other side, big defensive stand here. If you could force him to try a field goal and go down only 13-6 rather than 17-6, that's a huge play. It's a big defensive series right here.
Third and goal, 15th play of the Oklahoma drive at the Aggie 5. Hybl trying to get the snap. Lobs it in the corner. Fagan, did he get in? No. Did not get his feet down.
Incomplete.
Incomplete.
Good play call. Just didn't get it executed as well as they'd like to. Throw it to the back of the end zone. Enough teams don't try this. They don't throw it in the back of the end zone. I think you're going to see his foot is out.
Yeah, it's a good call.
Right now, the first foot is down.
Yep, left one's out, right one's out. Field goal unit is out as well.
Now watch it.
This one.
They got tricks here.
Yeah, they got tricks.
Bob Stoops got lots of tricks. He pulled one of these earlier against Missouri.
And 2 years ago here against A&M. They'll kick it. 22 yards and they'll make it. So they just stay with the plan, trying to be solid, not make any mistakes. And they go up by seven now. So DiCarlo's hit from 25. And 22. DiCarlo's kick is short. Taken by one of the up men at about the 18-yard line. And maybe out to the 22. And that was Archie McDaniel on the kick return. So now a minute 24 remaining. And A&M has all of its timeouts. That last drive, by the way, for the 3 points for Oklahoma. 16 plays.
Huge drive.
They used almost 7 minutes, but had to settle for three.
Well, that's the good news and the bad news. You had the ball, you took it, you held the ball away from your opponent, but you only came away with 3 points. But Neal's still the quarterback.
Neal being the shotgun, they'll work from the 22-yard line. Terrence Murphy, the guy that caught the touchdown pass, is to his right. He's looking that way, and now he's going to try to take off with it. But he's all wrapped up by Corey Klein. One of the defensive tackles out of Tulsa. And there's Mark Ferris on the right with a baseball cap that Bob spoke of, the starting quarterback for 2 years here.
Yep.
And the guy with all the experience. And
he was 27 years old starting out the season, and the other kid, the young kid, is right here, the 18-year-old.
Neal pulls it down. Reggie will run with it. Across the 30 and spinning out to the 35.
And that's what he brings to the table right there. He doesn't have the experience that Mark Ferris, the 27-year-old quarterback, does. But he's got the athletic ability and the surprise. You got something that nobody's got. I mean, if everything breaks down, I can just take off and run.
He got out to the 35-yard line. First down. Set to throw this time. Fires a little bit low. Did he make the catch? Yes. Nope. Wait a minute. Umpire says no. And he had a better view of it. Terrence Thomas was the intended receiver. It was delivered low. And Terrence isn't saying much about it. So
that's usually a dead giveaway.
Yeah, that's a one-hopper.
That's skipped in there.
Yep. Boom.
That was good teamwork by the officials.
Sure was. One was screened from view, and the other one was right in the middle and could see it all. So brings up second down and 10. McNeal. Lost in the pocket again, but throws to Murphy down the middle. Everidge got a big hit on him, but he got a first down out at the 49, almost midfield.
Reggie McNeal doing a nice job. He's run enough that if he scrambles around, they have to respect the ability that he might run again, and that opens up things in the secondary.
Blitz. Get rid of it, Reggie. And he tossed it. He got it complete at the 40. And Murphy was falling down. In fact, had fallen down. He still made the catch.
Yeah, well, he had to throw this ball long before Murphy made his move, so he had just had to guess where he was going to be on that out route.
And Corey Klein popped him as soon as he let go of it, so it's a first down. Aggies still with time. 20 seconds left in the half. Out of the shotgun again. McNeal waiting, waiting. Finally going deep. Got Porter out there. Touchdown! What a catch!
What a throw!
The 12th man just woke up. Yard touchdown at the last possible moment. McNeal let it go, and Porter made a sensational catch in the back of the end zone. Pegram to try to tie it. Pearson to try to tie it, and he barely tucks it in the right upright. Tie ball game. Let's take another look.
Reggie McNeal has just come in and put a shot under this crowd. The 12th man, as you said, Brad. Watch this. Everything's going to be covered. Now you should throw it now. Throw it now. No, I'm just saying, I'm staying around. Now he throws it over. Look at this. The two safeties are here. He's trying to get it over both of them to Porter from a flat-footed stance.
Wow.
We told you that Porter was going to be working down the middle early in the ball game. We said this. They wanted to get it to Porter over the middle. He down the middle of the field. Just that's a great throw. And a good catch.
Jonathan Jackson's the guy that levels McNeal. Reggie still looking sideways through legs and going touchdown.
I like that, huh?
That's a good look. Good job, Reggie. 13-13. 4th touchdown catch of the year for Porter. And again, the ball with the wind here rolls off the tee. A&M had 3 timeouts left, didn't use any, and they score a touchdown with 7 seconds to go.
Well, that's college football, because when you make first downs, the clock stops and you can get the next playoff without using them.
Skate kick. Is a big blast out of the end zone again. So no time off the clock. 7 seconds coming up for Oklahoma. We assume they would take a knee and head to the locker room tied with Texas A&M. Surprisingly tied at Kyle Field right now.
Let's point out that offensive line of A&M doing a nice job of giving the quarterbacks for them time to throw. He had all day.
There's Dino Babers talking with his protege, Reggie McNeal. I tell you what, when Swanee told Reggie yesterday, son, you got to put more on the ball, I think he listened.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's throwing it, and the great thing about that throw was he threw it into the end zone, and he stood in the pocket and didn't run with the ball.
He stood in, took a big lick. Porter made a great catch.
Sunday on ESPN Classic. All she wants is to coach football.
Now, what do you say?
Why don't you quit so we can get us a real coach?
But is she tough enough? Is she man enough to turn these losers?
Do you want to play football?
Yeah.
Into winners. Wesley Snipes, Woody Harrelson, and Goldie Hawn. Wildcats. On Real Classics, where the worlds of sports and movies collide. 8 p.m. Sunday on ESPN Classic.
Hey, here's Bob, the host with the most, you might say. And here's his buddy, Tom. Looks like Tom could use a little help. So Bob did the buddy thing and told Tom to call and order Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. Well, Tom got his Enzyte, and look at him now. Yes, in just a few short weeks, he's stepping large and laughing easy.
Free samples of Enzyte now available while supplies last. Just call or visit for Enzyte.com. Enzyte, the once-a-day tablet for natural male enhancement.
This is Bob. Bob is playing well. That's because not long ago, Bob decided to go big time. New clothes, new clubs, and a call to Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. And in just a few short weeks, Bob has a big new swing of confidence, a little well-earned respect, and a very happy partner back at the clubhouse.
Free samples of Enzyte now available while supplies last. Just call or visit for Enzyte.com. Enzyte, the once-a-day tablet for natural male enhancement.
Back at Kyle Field, halftime, 13-13, Oklahoma and Texas, and we're right about up in there, about the 50-yard line. Welcome back, everybody. Brad Nessler and Bob Greasy. Partner, good game. Two different ways these teams went about getting 13 points. Oklahoma did it kind of the hard way, and A&M did it with quick strikes.
They both did it on their last two possessions of the half. Oklahoma taking a 10 and 16 plays, and they only got field goals. A&M took it 4 and 5 plays on their two possessions, but they got touchdowns on both of theirs.
In the second quarter, it was time to reveal Reggie McNeal, and he went to work, hit Terrence Murphy, 51-yard quick strike touchdown. And then right before the half, he waited and waited, took a huge shot and let go deep, and Greg Porter got it in the back of the end zone, tied it up at 13.
No question, Reggie McNeal is a story of the first half coming on, and for the last four series, got him two touchdowns and some big plays.
And the Aggies will have the ball first two, a yard deep. Jason Carter will bring it out on the kick return. And Carter's got a little opening. Tripped up, though. Got to about the 28-yard line. Let's check in with Swanee.
Well, Bob and Brad, you're right. Reggie McNeal was the story. And R.C. Slocum re-emphasized the fact that it was always in his game plan to put Reggie into the ball game. But coming back out for the second half, you'll see the man behind center for the second half getting the start will be number 16, Reggie McNeal. I talked to Mike Stoops. I asked him if this changed his game plan. He says, absolutely. We have to be aware of Reggie McNeal, know where he is at all times. He is a different asset. We have to drop back in our coverage and be aware that he can run the football. Brad?
All right, Lynn. From the 28, on the ground, on the draw. Holy mackerel. What a hit that was by Jackson and Lance Mitchell. Our Pacific Live game summary statistically in the first half. As we take a look, you see the time of possession. That's what Bob and I were talking about. You can have it all day long, but if the other team hits it in a hurry, it doesn't really matter.
You got to convert. Red zone points 13 for OU. I mean, they've been inside and only kicked field goals a couple times. A&M is scoring from outside.
That's right. They didn't need to get in the red zone. They did it from farther out. Second down and 12 here. And we've got a timeout already. We'll take a timeout with him. Mike Stoops comes out to talk to his defense with 14-18 to go, third quarter.
Wrangler Jeans Company, a new generation of Wrangler. New fits, new fabrics, new styles.
Hello.
Yo.
Where are you?
I'm in London. Where are you?
We're in Paris. Thought you were in Tokyo.
Thought you were in Boston.
Change of plans. What's up?
Change of plans. We need to reroute the shipment.
New terms?
New terms, new specs, new schedules.
Show me.
There you go.
Change of plans. Okay, will do. See you in New York.
Change of plans. See you in L.A.
Au revoir.
Sayonara.
So what's up? The usual.
When change is part of the plan, that's on-demand business from IBM.
One of the reasons we play so well on the road is because we have a team out.
And then what happened?
John Elway drove 98 yards.
She definitely cares about what we eat.
Ooh, Miss McNabb.
Al, keep driving.
Oh, come on. For away games, she loves giving us Campbell's chunky soup and microwavable bowls. She makes the road feel like home.
Campbell's Chunky. It fills you up right.
Are the brake pads and shoes really guaranteed for as long as I own my car?
Yes.
What if I need additional work?
We'll explain it all before we do anything.
In a written estimate?
Yes.
Could you read that last answer back for me, please?
Yes.
Visit Midas now and get brake pads or shoes for just $39.95 plus installation. We'll provide a written estimate for installation and fully explain any additional work needed. For mechanics known for their work and their word,
trust the Midas touch.
The NBA on ESPN Wednesday doubleheader. Can King James turn the Cavaliers into contenders? Are C-Webb and the Kings still one of the best out west? It all tips off with Kia NBA Shootaround, Wednesday at 7:30 on ESPN.
Saturday on ESPN Classic. At 8, it's Sports Century Chuck Bednarik. At 9 and 9:30, a double dose of classics hit comedy Cheap Seats. Then at 10, a Colts-Dolphins showdown from 71. Tonight on ESPN Classic.
Reggie McNeal didn't get the play in time. He was making the motion like hurry up, and he had to call the timeout after the one play here in the third quarter. Now he goes back to work, and he goes back in the pocket and finds Lance Mitchell to say hello. Denny Lehman was there too, and a loss of four.
Well, this Oklahoma defense has come out fired up, and they know they got to set the tempo. They're frustrated. They've got two touchdowns scored on them the last two possessions. Two inside linebackers, 10 and 11, Mitchell and Lehman, mixing it up in there, and you know, there's a lot of things going through that freshman quarterback's head right now.
Including Lance Mitchell's helmet.
This is a darn good defense for him to try to be doing some stuff against.
So it's backed up to the 22-yard line, third down and 16. Not the spot he wanted to get in on the opening series of the third. He'll run a quarterback draw here, right by the umpire, into the open field. He's got a first down and then some. Reggie McNeal all the way to the 45-yard line. That's something Bob talked about, and he gives him that nobody else can.
And there's no question about it. My thought when he dropped back was, all right, you're backed up, first possession, just don't make a mistake, don't turn it over. I thought the play call was great, a quarterback draw. Now, he makes something out of it. Do you remember a kid by the name of Brad Smith?
Absolutely. Gave him fits, gave Oklahoma fits,
exactly.
Almost beat him.
Missouri quarterback, redshirt freshman, gained a lot of yardage. McNeil's starting to do the same thing.
First down after a 33-yard run. Now he fakes it to Weber, keeps it himself. Lehman's there to turn him in. And then Tommy Harris makes the tackle.
Number 16, Reggie.
Got about 2.5 on that one.
Yard line.
This is a proud defense, Mitchell and Lehman and that crew.
We were talking to Mike Stoops before, and he was talking to R.C. Slocum, and he said, those two junior college linebackers that we got, Mitchell and Jackson, he said, really saved us. He says, we really needed some help immediately. Mitchell was supposed to go to Florida, then went to a junior college.
Right.
And then because he couldn't get something wrong with a class, he got into Oklahoma. He couldn't go back to Florida.
He was one English credit shy as far as Florida's program was concerned. Here comes Joe Weber. Weber in the clear. Brandon Everidge saved a touchdown. 25 yards for Weber.
The whole thing turned around on that draw play on third down by Reggie McNeal. Oklahoma came out and dominated the first two plays from the line of scrimmage. And now A&M is on a roll.
Kevin Sumlin told us the seniors have got to take a leadership role. He said, Joe Weber, this is a personal thing for him. This is his last crack at Oklahoma. We expect him to play well. He's got to lead us. He is right now.
And Billy Yates and Taylor Whitley, the two senior guards out in front of that play.
First down at the 17-yard line. A&M threatening to score on their opening possession of the third quarter. McNeal, pump fake, pump and go, got a man, touchdown! Bethel Johnson! His first catch of the day, couldn't have come at a better moment. They bid on the out and up. The pump fake was perfect, so was the throw. Touchdown, Aggies. They take the lead on Oklahoma for the first time today. Pegram for the point after. Got it this time. A stunning end to the second quarter, a stunning beginning to the third quarter. Reggie McNeal putting on a show. The Aggies lead Oklahoma 20-13.
I'm no car expert, but...
But I do know what I want.
You know what I want?
More bang.
Bang for my buck.
More bang for my buck.
From a car and...
A car company.
That's why I got a Forenza.
By Suzuki.
Suzuki! Woo!
Protected by America's number one warranty.
Numero uno.
And it's got more room and more features
than Civic.
Than a Civic.
Forenza.
It gives so much.
And it asks so little. Who says you can't have it all?
Forenza!
Forenza!
I will not be afraid of the dark.
I will not feel guilty leaving my dog alone.
I will know my children are safe.
I will finally be able to relax!
A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide. Call now and you may qualify to get an ADT system installed for zero down, plus save up to 20% on your homeowner's insurance. Call now. ADT. Always there.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. This is where I get my Dave magic going. I should, shh. Okay. Oh, one Best Buy buck. You get in that zone and you really start to feel like this mantra, this really like good kind of...
One Best Buy
one
buck.
One Best Buy buck. I want a pony, David.
All right. That's cool. I mean,
no, David, I didn't win a pony. I won one Best Buy buck.
The Monopoly Best Chance game at McDonald's is back. Get large fries or chicken selects and you win, guaranteed.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
Oh, David. Yeah.
You should be happy. You got magic, David.
Ever wondered what it's really like to be a soldier?
What do you got?
I have a sit rep from Alpha Company.
Big T, ready to be verified. Verified!
Put yourself in the picture with this free video. You'll see over 200 great jobs in the Army and over 180 in the Army Reserve. You'll also see what skills you learn, how you can earn money for college, even what soldiers do in their free time. Call 1-800-984-ARMY now and get this free t-shirt and your free video. Put yourself in the picture and see what it's really like to become an Army of One.
Peyton Manning.
He grab his team by the throat and take along with him.
Sports Century Monday. His family's reputation.
The Manning name has to be important to him.
His search for perfection.
He'll study film from 7 in the morning until 11 at night, 7 days a week.
But can he win the...
I want to be in year 15 or 16 saying, boy, I hope I can keep playing one more year so we can win a Super Bowl.
Sports Century Peyton Manning. 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central. Monday on ESPN Classic.
Young quarterback, Reggie McNeal, growing up very quickly. Watch as he's going to pump right here, and then he just lofts it. He sees he's got the man beat, and just don't miss him, and he does it. Now, here's what he did. The receiver, Bethel Johnson, right there, straight comes up, thinks it's going to be a hitch like they've been throwing a lot today, and that's just good pressure playing by the receiver and the quarterback.
Here's a kick. Deep, hits the goal line and bounces out of bounds in the end zone, touchback. So all of a sudden, the Aggies 5-4, flag down on the kick. They lead Oklahoma with 14 unanswered points, courtesy of two touchdown passes by that young fella. 72 yards, he did a bunch of it on that 33-yard quarterback draw, then he got 25 from Weber, and then a perfectly executed stop-and-go route. And he hit his man in the corner of the end zone. First time Johnson's caught it, and it was a touchdown.
Encroachment by the kicking team. 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
And one of the keys here is that they did that into the wind.
Mm-hmm.
Texas A&M received at the beginning of the game, and now they just received the opening second half kickoff. That's because of Oklahoma at the beginning of the game. They wanted to win. The
right.
Win was such a factor that they took the win, and because they took their choice, the second half choice was A&M's, and they took the ball again.
And went right down the field, scored. Bethel's going to stay warm after that touchdown. There's the wind, as we told you before the game. 20 to 30 miles an hour heading that way.
And if you wait a minute, it'll change and go the other way.
That's true. And they're going to have to hold the football again to kick. Sammy Davis will hold it.
This happened a couple of years ago when they were down there. They got down by, what, 10 points in the fourth quarter?
They got saved by Oklahoma. The defense. Defense actually won the game with an interception return for
Marshall,
a touchdown.
Marshall, the middle linebacker.
Yep.
Remember that play.
Terrance Marshall saved their season. Now it might be up to Teddy Lehman and Lance Mitchell and that group to save it. Cody Skates with a kick. This one's returnable by Antoine Savage. Savage across the 25, out to about the 27-yard line. Let's go back and look at the touchdown one more time.
Well, here you go. It's just it's a hitch and go. It's a little hitch there, straight. Who they throw these in front of him before. Now he bites on it, and it's just, you got to take your time. Bethel Johnson did a great job of selling it, and that's why it was so open, because it was single coverage, and he just sold the route.
That gave you a beautiful picture of the corner biting on a good execution play by a wide receiver and a quarterback, and the swing pass intended for Quentin Griffin is incomplete.
All right, let me tell you what you got right here. Oklahoma is, they've had pressure being number one, but now they're behind for the first time in the second half. And now they see that, everybody's telling us how good we are. We're going to be at the Fiesta Bowl, the championship game. Hey, we're down 7 points in the second half on the road to a good team. Now somebody's got to step up and score some points.
We got to get out of College Station before we go any farther west.
They got five games left, including this one. That's a lot of football to play.
This crowd's getting noisy now. A lot of silent counts by Hybl. High snap. Give inside. Quentin Griffin trying to weave. And does for about four, but that's it. Ryan Gamble and Penright and on the stop.
Brad and Bob, I want to go back to what I said at the beginning of the ball game when I said this is the time of the year where attitude plays such an important part. And it's obvious that Texas A&M came in with the attitude they wanted to play this ball game, had a lot to prove. Now, Mike Stoops said on the field before the ball game, the one thing he did want to have is this team great confidence of having the crowd still in the ball game, and they're right on top of it now.
Boy, are they ever.
Hybl.
Third down and five.
Hybl been pretty good on third downs.
Almost perfect. Needs one here. Blitz coming. Lobs it. Got a man open. Got him on the run, and it's Fagan. And Fagan is gone. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
Boy, you can't do it any better than that. You're looking a little shabby, maybe. They shoot you down. We'll come right back and score a touchdown right on top of it. That's pretty good.
Longest play of the year for the Sooners. Hybl laid it beautifully on Fagan. 68 yards, touchdown.
Mentioned it, partner. Blitz single coverage, and he just beat the coverage and then outran it.
Boy, we had a couple pretty passes back to back, haven't we? Point away from being tied up again. Trey DiCarlo to try to even it up, and does. What a start to the third quarter at Kyle Field. 10:33 remaining in the third. Sooners going deep, tying it at 20.
In the mood for something grilled? Stouffer's makes it easy. The new grilled chicken entrees. A grilled herb rub chicken breast seared over an open flame to seal in its juices and served with tender linguine and a medley of crisp vegetables tossed in a light tomato herb sauce. As for your grill, put it on ice. Stouffer's new grilled herb chicken, one of four new grilled chicken entrees from Stouffer's.
Sunday on ESPN Classic. All she wants is to coach football.
Now what do you say?
Why don't you quit so we can get us a real coach?
But is she tough enough? Is she man enough to turn these losers?
Do you want to play football?
Yeah.
Into winners. Wesley Snipes, Woody Harrelson, and Goldie Hawn. Wildcats. On Real Classics, where the worlds of sports and movies collide. 8 p.m. Sunday on ESPN Classic.
Own a timeshare? Turn it into cash.
Timeshares only got us our full asking price in just a few weeks.
We couldn't believe it.
Own a campground membership? Turn it into cash.
Timeshares only sold our campground membership fast.
And
for the price we wanted.
Timeshares Only is the nation's largest, number one, most successful timeshare agency.
We represent properties from the biggest names in the timeshare industry.
When it comes to selling, renting, or buying timeshares, no one comes close to Timeshares Only.
With over $2 billion of timeshares sold in the last 6 months, now's the perfect time to sell, rent, or buy. And no one sells more timeshares than we do.
We work for Timeshares Only.
And our timeshare was rented before the next monthly payment was due.
You owe it to yourself to work with the best. Timeshares Only, the most trusted name in timeshares.
Call 800-789-0044 to sell, rent, or buy your timeshare and get your free information kit. Don't delay. Call 800-789-0044 now.
Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, and our ABC crew, College Station, Texas. What a Big 12 football game this has become. 10:33 remaining in the third quarter. If you just joined us, Texas A&M opened up the third quarter with a quick scoring drive, and Oklahoma's just answered. Three plays, 73 yards, their longest play of the year. Curtis Fagan, number 12, there on the kickoff team. A touchdown catch from Nate Hybl. It was impressive. Really impressive. And this kick is deep. Carter can't handle it in the sun. And it'll be the 20-yard line for Texas A&M.
Let's go.
So as they say down here in Texas, this one's fixing to get good.
There's a blitz. Now watch the linebackers. They're going to come from this side here and here and here. I mean, this is perfect. As a quarterback, you love this. And I'm sure Swanee down at the other end, he would love this. Single coverage, you don't have to worry about any help. Just throw it over number 11, Jones's head, and you got six.
Swanee, he never even had to move his hands. He didn't even put his hands up.
Well, that was a perfect thing, and he didn't break stride. It was absolutely perfect.
And then he ran away from him. He had the speed not to get caught.
Thomas Carragher, the tight end, came out of his stance. That'll be a five-yard penalty against Texas A&M.
Well, Brett.
Go ahead, Swanee.
Well, Brett and Bob, we often talk about those passes being thrown, and in many cases you're just a bit behind or just too far out in front or too low. Doesn't give the receiver the opportunity to make the catch and then do something with the ball. Here's a perfect case of all you had to do was catch it and he was going to score, but it had to be a perfect pass, and that's exactly what it was.
No doubt about it. First and 15 at the 15. Got five. The door closed in a hurry. Brandon Everidge made the stop from his safety position. Back to the original line of scrimmage.
Terrence Thomas, the receiver, just kind of standing around there. Got into some of that backwash.
That's exactly what it was. Second and 10 coming up.
Weber's going to say, hey, if you were blocking down there, you wouldn't
might have been way down there.
Right. I wouldn't have knocked you over.
Three wideouts, including Terrence Thomas, who comes out here to the right side. A four wideout grouping. They go on the ground the other way, though, and Weber's all wrapped up by Jonathan Jackson. Jackson's had a nice game from his defensive end spot. He's kind of staying home and sliding down the line, making some tackles. A sophomore out of Houston. Didn't play too far from here in his high school ball. The Sooners band is here. I don't think they expected to be in the battle that they're in. There's the third down conversion story for A&M. Third and nine. McNeal stands and waits. Tipped. And it's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Bassey. Tip ball by Mitchell, the linebacker, I think. And Bassey's got another interception. Second one for Oklahoma today.
Well, we said, they're second in the nation in turnover margin. It's 28 now on the year, 28 takeaways.
Including 18 interceptions.
Yes. And they get a lot of them. From behind the defense, watch number 10. I think Lehman's going to be the guy that tips it.
Mitchell,
right here. Number 10, watch him.
Yep, there it is.
That ball was not thrown that well. He should have thrown it inside of Mitchell, way to the inside where the receiver was coming. That was not a good throw.
At the 32. They fake it. They might want it all on the first play. Fagan again. Incomplete. Nice coverage back there by Keelan Jackson. You could just feel that one coming, faking that draw and then trying to get a quick six.
I like the call. Chuck Long, the offensive coordinator, the passing game, going right after it. I like that. Play action pass down the field.
Under Bob Stoops, they've had a lot of scoring drives that haven't lasted long. Second down and 10. Hybl may have changed things a bit at the line. Again, silent count. A little bit of option going right. Quentin Griffin on the run. Penalty markers are down. Might have a holding call out there. We've had very few flags today.
Yes, you're right.
And it is holding against Oklahoma. You know, you talk about the offense and Bob Stoops, sometimes people say, well, do they play to lose? They play to win? Are they conservative on offense? See, an answer for us.
It's never been our job. It's never been our focus just to try and hold on to the ball. We make big plays. We throw the ball downfield. Three touchdown passes versus Colorado last week. We've rushed for over 200 yards two of the last three games. I think we rushed for 199 in the other. Now, we want our offense to move the ball, and we're aggressive with it. But, sure, we want to be smart and make sure we're always responsible with the ball.
He doesn't miss much.
No, he doesn't. You better know what you're asking
him. Oh, yes.
He'll give you an answer.
He'll set you straight, that's for sure.
Second down at 17. 8:30 to go, third quarter, tie game. Here comes a blitz on Hybl. Going deep again, but his receiver went one way. The pass went the other as Antoine Savage broke to the post and Hybl threw to the flag. Incomplete, nobody
home. That's a great shot there. You see Peoples shaking his head and Hybl looking at him. They got to be on the same street.
Maybe Peoples
heard the hook, but he didn't hear the go part.
Yeah.
Now it's third down long. Third time today that Oklahoma's been in a third and 10 or more situation. Here comes the crowd to life for the Wrecking Crew. Let's see what happens from the 38-yard line. Trying to take advantage of Bassey's interception. Hybl across the middle. Savage trying to make something out of it, but way too many maroon jerseys around him. He got back to about the 28-yard line.
Maybe got him back into field goal range. Be a 45-yarder?
See what they do. Hibble's going to trot off. He would have the wind at Trey DeCarlo's back. And here he comes, the freshman. This time last year, he was going to the homecoming dance. Now he's playing big-time football.
And he's done pretty well, too.
Yes, he has. He's hit two today. He hit two last week and missed two last week. This one from 45 yards out.
Downwind.
DeCarlo, kick on the way. It is perfect.
Sure.
Got it. Add three more, and Oklahoma takes the lead back. Bob Stoops says, we'll take it. They turn Eric Bassey's interception again into points. Oklahoma by a field goal.
Chevy Colorado Z71 with an available 220 horsepower engine.
You're it.
Don't let all that power go to your head. Chevy Colorado, an American revolution.
Showtime.
It's the Incredibles Pringles Prince with the incredible superheroes and movie quotes on the Pringles you love. There's printed fun on every one. It's the Incredibles Pringles Prince. They make lunchtime an incredible time. Disney presents a Pixar film, The Incredibles, rated PG in theaters November 5th.
Red Sox fans, celebrate Boston's amazing World Series victory with three great gifts from Sports Illustrated. You'll get this officially licensed signature baseball in a specially designed display case and Sports Illustrated's World Series commemorative book, all free with your paid subscription. Remember this historic team forever with the ultimate collectible, a baseball with signatures from the World Series champions, Ortiz, Pedro, Schilling, Damon, Manny, Veritek, and more. Display your championship ball inside this high-quality case engraved with the Boston Red Sox and World Series logos. Call now and you'll also receive SI's special World Series commemorative book featuring the historic come-from-behind win over the Yankees, SI's picks for the greatest Boston Red Sox players of all time, and more. Your gifts are free when you order 56 issues of SI for only $1.59 an issue. You'll save 60% off the cover price. Own a piece of Red Sox history with three great collectibles from Sports Illustrated. Call now.
On the next Cheap Seats.
A fat tranny in hot pants.
Who's your granddaddy?
Who's your granddaddy?
Roller Games, 10 Eastern Thursday on ESPN Classic.
All of my fantasies are coming true, but I can't believe it. Wait a minute. I'm losing fake control here.
It's here. Another legend is now on ESPN Classic. 60 Minutes on Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesdays.
Here we go. McNeal draw play inside. Across the 50, down about the 48-yard line. Hartler Fleming's first carry of the day. Fleming and Weber doing the job that Derek Farmer normally would do. Derek not playing today. And the backs have done a nice job. They got to keep Oklahoma honest in case there's a play action somewhere on Reggie's sleeve that he's looking at. Second down. And a long five coming up, but in Oklahoma territory. Aggies trailing by three, final 2.5 minutes, third quarter. McNeal, quick drop. The throw is complete. It's going to be short of the first down by about a yard, I think, to Bethel Johnson. And that will bring up third down and one.
I'm impressed the way young Reggie McNeal, like again, he hasn't played, coming into this ball game, he had thrown let me get the numbers for you. It was 12 of 26, two touchdowns, two, only 46%. This kid is becoming of age here today.
Third down, short two. And Oklahoma jumps offside, ball came loose, but taking a knee was Reggie McNeal. Dvorak was offside, I believe.
Yeah.
Fell out of his stance right there by the center, and quickly Hangartner snapped the ball. Here's the call.
Offside on the defense. 5 yard penalty. First down.
Watch number 94.
Dvorak right there.
Now that's good cadence. That's the, you know, and I've said this many a time, that the guys you can affect the most are those guys right in front of you, right over the guard or the center, because they can hear the inflection of your voice the best. And if you had a non-rhythmic cadence, you know, and if they're not paying attention, you would think just watch the ball and go.
So it's an automatic first down at the 40. Might be a blitz coming from the secondary here from Oklahoma. There's the play action I talked about. Here comes a deep ball. Murphy! Touchdown! Second touchdown for Murphy. One was 51, one was 40, and Reveille is loving it. The Aggies are back in front.
With play action.
Extra point is good. Two touchdowns, 128 yards. Look at that average. When you got 51 and 40 for your two touchdowns, that average is going to be pretty good. Brandon Everidge fell down on that play.
He sure did. Their leading receiver not playing today, Jamar Taylor. He said at the beginning of the game, they're just going to put somebody up in there, Bethel Johnson. Here's Bethel, straight working on him. The problem is Everidge in the center of the field, number 7, falls down.
Terrence Murphy, second touchdown.
He was expecting some help and didn't get it.
Well, Bob and Brad, you're talking about Reggie McNeal and how calm and how great he's playing against a good defense. I think one of the things that helps him be calm in that pocket and play a good game is the fact that his quarterback coach, Dino Babers, is right there on the sideline with him.
Yeah.
He has a chance to talk to him when he comes to the sideline. They go over things. Right now, he's sitting on the bench next to his quarterback. Calming effect on that young man.
So McNeil to Murphy, two long ones.
And I'll tell you what, success will bring you along quicker than anything.
What's up, Mom?
I'm sure he's had some struggles along the way. But you throw touchdown passes, and that'll boost your confidence.
Sure will. For Reggie, more touchdown passes in this game than in his career. Three today. Here's the last one.
Right here. Watch Everidge. He's in the middle of the field. It's going to be a play-action pass. He sees the play-action. Now he doesn't get deep enough. And when the ball does go over his head, look at this.
He's down.
He's on the ground, and he should be deep, helping straight out. Straight was expecting some help in the middle of the field.
So now Oklahoma will work from the 35 as a kick went out of bounds. And they're trailing again. Remember, they didn't trail for long last time, about a minute and 13 seconds before they regained the lead. This time they trail by four. Nate Hybl across the middle. Trent Smith on the run. The big tight end fumbled it, but I think he fell right back on top.
I don't know if he got it or not.
No, maybe not. A&M's got it. Randall Webb's got it. I thought Smith fell on his own fumble, but Randall Webb ripped it out of there.
This is a tough place to play right here, boy. It is loud. It's intimidating. He's got it. Tuck it away. Now he goes after it again, and he just doesn't get it.
Gamble's the one that made the hit that forced the fumble. Here's another look.
Oklahoma's been living on the turnovers all year. This is a takeaway that may cost them.
At the 42-yard line. Weber up the middle. Joe Weber cartwheeled, but he got a first down, and he got all the way to the 31-yard line. Boy, are they excited right now. First down at the 31-yard line. 82 yards for Joe Weber. He stepped up to the plate, hasn't he? There's the wrecking crew. There's the guy that fumbled after the reception. And now the A&M offense again to work at the 31. Weber again. Met in the hole.
It's over, fellas. It's over.
Only got about a yard to the 30. Pasha Jackson put it down. Our Chrysler passing playbook, Bob.
Let's talk passing a little bit. I want to talk to you about the influence of the quarterback's eyes. If he looks over here, you can affect this guy. Now watch as he drops back to pass. He's going to be looking to our left. See that right there? He looked left first. This holds him. He wants to throw the ball over to the right side. Young quarterbacks don't realize enough what you can do with your head and your eyes in moving defensive players around.
Second down and nine. Final half minute, third quarter at the 30-yard line. Weber, draw play. No, kept by McNeil. Reggie on the run. Down to the 11-yard line. He had me.
I was fooled too.
I bit on the fake and he took off 24 yards.
I think I just let him keep it all the time. This young kid was one of the top, if not the top, one or two high school quarterbacks in the state of Texas last year. He's doing the same thing to Oklahoma that Brad Smith, the quarterback in Missouri, did. He's running all over the place on this good defense.
Three tight end offense as the quarter ends. And now, when they start singing their song and start swaying back and forth, this place is starting to move on us. The end of three, a possible upset in the making. Texas A&M 27, Oklahoma 23.
chicken, mashed potatoes, corn and pudding.
You?
A sliver of trout spritzed with lemon and maybe carrots!
Shoulda had Hungry Man from Swanson. A whole pound of the good hearty food that men love. Hungry Man, it's good to be full.
Frank!
We thought they'd never find us. We were wrong.
No enemy has ever withstood our might.
I need a weapon.
There are those who send this day. What are they to say now?
Rated M for mature.
Remember that guy who used to be called Wild Thing? The guy who wanted to spend the entire honeymoon indoors? Remember the one who couldn't resist a little mischief? Yeah, that guy. He's back. Viagra. Not all medications are for everyone. Ask your doctor if Viagra is right for you.
You ever think you might have worms? If your computer is slowing down or crashing or just acting weird.
E-acceleration with the full power of Stop Sign can make it like new again.
Stop Sign gives you virus protection second to none.
With a spam blocker and spyware remover.
Pop-up blocker.
And the Stop Sign firewall for all the protection you'll ever need.
Guaranteed.
You may be infected and not even know it. Go to StopSign.com for a free virus scan now.
There's what I was talking about, going to the break. And quite a break it was.
Update that file, Bill.
And now they sway down to the 6-yard line. First and goal. Weber hit immediately.
It's over, it's
actually
over.
Lost. About a half yard. Tommy Harris made the hit. Second down and goal coming up for the Aggies. They lead 27-23. Start of the fourth quarter. With Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, and our ABC crew, Brad Nessler with you from College Station. Looking on, Tex and Marjorie Wright. Tex says, I've only been watching football about 54 years. Actually, he said he's 89, he's going to turn 90 next birthday, was last Saturday, so he's lying about his age. But he said he's seen a lot of great players. Bob asked him about who's the best quarterback. And at halftime, he said to me, you know what, Brad? I like Reggie McNeil's release. That's a fan. Here's Reggie, pump fake, looking for a release. He'll release himself. Runs inside, got back to the line of scrimmage. You can get some good stories from football fans like Tex.
I was interested talking to him. Tex, how come you've been living so long? He said, I said, you're drinking a little Diet Coke every now and then. I said, yeah, I used to, you know. And I said, smoke cigars, yeah. I give those up, though.
I thought he had the right grasp on life. I'm going to be an old guy. I'm going to follow his pattern.
Whatever you were doing, we want to follow.
That's right. He does most of the stuff I do, so maybe I'll be doing this a while. Third down and goal. Oklahoma thinking about a blitz. And here they come. Inside handoff. Fumble! Fallen. Texas A&M recovered it, but it's going to be fourth down. And a nice job to get back on time of Taylor Whitley, the right guard, is the guy that fell on it.
It's a nice little sprint draw. Who hits
he
this
ball? He just
lost a hand. Who knocks this out? That's
Eric Bassey.
Average knocks it out.
And now it sets up the field goal attempt. The try, 24-yard kick. Pegram to try to extend the lead. Todd Pegram's kick is good. He got it. And they're up a touchdown now. Cody skates to kick after Pegram's field goal has put the Aggies up 7. And Skates has been blasting these things out of the end zone. This one 5 yards deep. They won't return it. Remember the last time at Kyle Field 2 years ago, as we take you back. Jamar Toombs, a 27-yard touchdown run in the fourth quarter, put A&M ahead by 10, 31-21. Quentin Griffin, touchdown run, pulled Oklahoma within 3. And then the play of the year. Terrance Marshall picked off Mark Ferris, returns it for the game-winning touchdown. The final is Oklahoma 35, Texas A&M 31.
They won that game and went on to win the national championship 2 years ago.
With a win over Florida State in the Orange Bowl. Oklahoma's last two drives, three and out. And a one play and then a fumble. This time, Quentin Griffin got four, maybe five.
Got you right here.
We're under 12 and a half minutes. Sooners in the fourth quarter have more than doubled their opponent. They're going to need some more of that Sooner magic. If there is such a thing, you can find it on the road in a place this rowdy.
Well,
that's what they're hoping for.
To win a championship along the way, there are going to be times like this. Sometimes you're going to have to be lucky. Sometimes you're going to have to be good enough to overcome the crowd and being behind in the fourth quarter into the win.
Hybl. Quick throw, incomplete. Peoples, the intended receiver. And it was behind him. Peoples went in. The pass went out. At the conclusion of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Bob Stoops cheering on his offense. Every other person decked in maroon cheering on the defense. Third down and six. The crowd will either get louder or Nate Hybl will quiet them right here.
You got single coverage on the outside on both sides.
Hybl lofts it down the middle. Got his man and he got it. Nope, incomplete. Nope, they're going to say a catch and then the ball came loose. It's Mark Clayton.
The back judge came forward and made a signal as if, yes, he caught it. Yes, he caught it.
I thought he caught it the first time we looked, and then you see the ball pop loose at the end. And we'll get another look.
There's nobody in the center of the field. The two wide receivers have single coverage. The one on our left runs the post. Well, let's see it again here.
Yep.
Yeah, he caught it.
He had it. Yep, it came out. Yeah, he even had his hand wrapped around it when he rolled.
And that official in the back made the call.
Hybl, play action. Going deep down the middle again, and again he's got it. Down to the 25-yard line. 21 yards to Peoples. It's 30-23 as we approach 11 minutes. First down, Oklahoma from the shotgun. Hybl again to throw. Fires sideline for Quentin Griffin and double covered over there.
Now he was throwing that one away, and he should have. Nobody open and just dumped it out of bounds. That's the nice thing about throwing on first down. You don't feel the pressure of having to stick it in there because you've got second and third down left to pick it up.
55 yards they've gone in a hurry. As we told you, they can strike. And they're fighting back. Second down and 10. Inside handoff, Quentin Griffin has done so many times. He's very close to a first down.
Well, what a great back.
He is.
Late in the game, when you need yardage, I mean, there's nothing better than have a guy you can count on. Number 22, the little draw, they're not sure whether you'll get it. Big number 70 in there for Davis. That's Shunsho.
And now they bring in Kewan Jones. He's their short yardage guy. They bring in an extra tight end as well. 10-20 left in the ballgame. Third down and a yard.
Fagan's been the guy they like on third down.
Got the yard and a bunch more. Close to the 10. Maybe even better that he was tackled at about the 11-yard line because now they can get a first down inside the 2. First and 10, Oklahoma.
So much for our defensive struggle as we talked about earlier.
That's right. That's going out the window.
Yes, sir.
Nice job of following Joseph, that freshman lineman Bob was talking about earlier.
Number 77.
Just put his hand on his butt. Says, I'm coming right after you. Down to the 11-yard line. Stoops looks up at the scoreboard. Sees that he's down 7. 8th play of the drive coming up, though. Trying to tie it up. Nate Hybl's going to call a timeout. 9:47 remaining in the ball game. Timeout, Oklahoma. Aggies leading the Sooners 30-23.
for perfection.
He's consumed by preparation.
But can he win the big one?
I want to be in year 15 or 16 saying, but hopefully win a Super Bowl.
Sports Century, Peyton Manning, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central, Monday on ESPN Classic.
Saturday on ESPN Classic. At 8, it's Sports Century, Chuck Butnarik. At 9 and 9:30, a double dose of classics hit comedy, Cheap Seats. Then at 10, a Colts-Dolphins showdown from 71. Tonight on ESPN Classic.
The average American household has nearly $8,000 in credit card debt. If you make only the minimum payments and have high interest rates, it could take you 47 years to pay them off. That's a scary thought. You can stop living in fear and get help. Call InCharge Debt Solutions. InCharge is a nonprofit credit counseling service. Our trained and certified counselors can discuss your options to get you out of debt and put you back in charge of your life. We work with creditors nationwide to reduce your interest rates and lower your monthly payments, helping you pay off your debt faster and more affordably than you could on your own. InCharge can stop the collection calls and design a solution that's right for you. Stop living in fear. Call today to get back in charge of your life.
.947 to play in regulation. Texas A&M leading Oklahoma 30-23. And they've got it. The Sooners do at the 11-yard line. First and 10.
That's the good news.
The bad news is
they haven't scored. They've struggled inside the 20-yard line all day today.
Three times in the red zone, they had to kick two field goals. And Reveille's got it figured out. You know what? She only barks when the Aggies are on defense. I like that. That's a good fan.
Yeah, it is. Just it only noise when we're on offense.
That's
just
right.
When we're on defense and the other team's out there.
They'll go from the spread again from the 11. Peoples and Savage to the left. Trent Smith's going to come in motion. Quentin Griffin flanking. Hybl in the gun. Nate looks right and left, in trouble, and down he goes. Sacked by Marcus Jasmine.
And Jasmine controls the center. 317 pounds, he has been very active all day long.
Second down and 14. Again, the Sooners could get a first down at the 1 yard line.
The defensive line leads the conference in sacks with 32 coming into play.
Hybl going left all the way this time, and incomplete, intended for Peoples again. And Penwright, the linebacker, was out there with him. Ty Warren, the All-American defensive end who was hurt early in the game, can only look on. He can't help his defense right now.
Well, there's plenty of time, 9 minutes to go. The thing you don't want to do is come out of here without points.
You at least need three if you're Oklahoma. Three wide outs and Trent Smith's in a slot.
And a lot of receivers down here, and Smith is in the middle, as you said.
Hybl looking that way, and incomplete. Intended for Clayton. Byron Jones was there. Sammy Davis was there.
And what a play it was by Byron Jones, guys. Watch as the receiver makes a move to the outside. Watch his right hand. He comes in. Boom, right there. Just strips it away from the receiver.
Boy, that's
great
perfect
play. Yeah, if he had not stripped the ball away, he would have turned into the end zone for a touchdown.
Good call, Swanee.
Right there.
Matt McCoy to hold. Trey DeCarlo has been perfect today. Three field goals in three tries. This one from 32 yards to try to cut in to the Aggie lead. Kick on the way, and it is good. So DeCarlo hits his fourth field goal momentarily, giving Bob Stoops Sooners a little bit of momentum, but they're still behind with 8:49 to play in the ballgame.
Right, momentum, you get 3 points off of that drive, it's a positive. Now you turn to the defense. All right, defense, get it back for us.
You're just joining us. You've missed a dandy, and we got a long ways to go. 8:49 left. That scoring drive, almost 4 minutes to get the field goal. And it cuts the Aggies' lead to 30-26.
The problem for Oklahoma has been their defense. They have not stopped the A&M offense.
Ever since Reggie McNeal came in.
Exactly, and they've scored in five of the last six drives.
Kick by DeCarlo into the wind, goes to the eight to Terrence Thomas. And Thomas up to about the 24. The Aggies are going to work.
Our hat a little bit to Kevin Sumlin, who has been calling the plays, the assistant head coach, who has been calling the plays since the third game, the fourth game of the season for the Aggies. And in those last seven games, they've been in the 30s four times, in the 30s three times, and in the 20s one time. So their average, a scoring average, the last seven games has been 37 points a game.
Their passing game just exploded since that time. And the freshmen's exploded onto the scene today. Here's the end around. Bethel Johnson. And he's hit out of bounds after a short gain. Derek Strait stayed home, made the play. Derek Strait, they picked on him a couple of times today.
Yep.
Oklahoma's defense came in 268, was sixth in the country. And today, 416 already for the Aggies.
Now, boys, I'm not trying to predict a play, but we saw a little skullduggery during the practice on Thursday, and the right personnel are in the ballgame for it.
And that would be an end-around pass. But this is McNeal. He's
blocked
one. And penalty markers, it's intercepted. Penalty marker, I think we're going to have either that pass interference or holding, but let's wait and see.
I think we're going to have interference on Oklahoma.
Bethel Johnson got bumped out of bounds before he ever had a chance to even come in to make a play on the ball. And it is pass interference on Oklahoma. Here's another look.
Take a look at it right here.
There was the push. Second one, and he's out of bounds.
Well, the reason that's interference is because the ball's in the air. You can jam him as long as he's not past you, as long as the ball's not in the air, but the ball was in the air.
So now McNeil's got a first down to work with at the 41-yard line. And he's going to run it himself all the way. Quarterback drawn, it didn't go anywhere. Oklahoma makes the stop. Pasha, or Jonathan Jackson, rather, and on the stop. Second and 11. Here comes a blitz off the corner. McNeil trying to get around it, but he can't.
Bassey gets him. He's got some speed. And this has been the guy that's been the thorn in their side is McNeal. And they finally get him down in open field for a loss.
Now here's the dangerous spot for Texas A&M. They've got third down and long coming up. And there's Bassey. He wasn't going to let him go.
Bassey is the guy that replaced Roy Williams. He's more of a corner and he's got the speed of a corner. It's a good thing he did because I don't think he would have brought him down had he not.
But redshirt freshman out of Garland, Texas.
All right, just don't make a big mistake
here.
That's
what I was talking about. Third down and 17. You don't want to make a misfire here. Because the Sooners could make you pay in a matter of seconds. Throws incomplete. Intended for Terrence Murphy, and it was nowhere near him. And so the Aggies have to give it up with 6:22 left. And another player down, and it's Jamie Hightower, and he goes back down. He's not getting up the left tackle. There's been some hitting going on today and some collisions and some pileups, and we've lost Ty Warren, and we also lost Brad Davis, offensive lineman for Oklahoma.
Yeah, Hightower, 75, is going to get hit from the behind.
There's the,
right,
oh boy.
Right there.
And yeah. Both ankles really buckled the wrong way.
Yeah. That's why all those offensive linemen, a lot of them, most all of them, wear the knee braces all the time, not only in games, but in practice as well.
And you can see he's got the knee braces. Now, there's not much you can do about the ankles, which both turned the wrong way there on that getting rolled up from behind situation. Cody skates. Remember, he had his longest career punt ever today, 67 yards. He's down at his own 20-yard line. Better get it away, boy. Straight was coming fast. Good kick. great kick again. They down it inside the five again.
Outstanding.
Sammy Davis.
You talk about special teams, this is what we're talking about. On the average, there's about 35 kicking situations a game. And if you can dominate those kicking situations, this is what we're talking about. Oklahoma having to start from their 2-yard line versus their 20 is huge.
Sammy Davis Jr., the candy man, can and did. Down it at the 2-yard line. And now it's a long way to go after another 64-yard punt. Oklahoma has 98 yards to go, 6 minutes, 12 seconds to do it in, or they can wave bye-bye to the Fiesta Bowl.
That's right. I can't tell you what starting back that far does to an offensive team. And encouraging for your defense.
The lights are on. The fans are up. As darkness starts to settle into Aggie Land. Sooners have to start in their own end zone. Play action. Hybl's going to go long. Down the middle. It's almost intercepted.
Should have been intercepted.
Terrence Kiel was back there and he didn't hold on to it.
Kiel was not fooled. The free safety in the center of the field was not fooled. Here he is here. It's going to be a play action into the line and he does not bite. Look at him. Back up. The receiver's to the right side. He looks at him and rolls immediately. Hybl doesn't throw it far enough. And the receiver does a nice job of shaking it loose.
That's right. Oklahoma's lucky that they didn't give it up right there. Second and 10. And it's Kewan Jones, and he gives him a little bit of room to work as he got it out across the 8-yard line. Pick up a 6.
Bob and Brad, sometimes things happen during the week that have an impact on your team dramatically. Number 43, Gerard Penright, made a couple of comments challenging his football team and saying they weren't playing very well. Well, he had to go in front of the team and apologize because he said the media took it wrong. It made it look like he was coming down on his players. But he did serve notice. He made everybody stop and think about how they were playing football, what level of intensity. They'd given up scores late in ball games. Today, they plan on not giving it back.
Let's see if they can stop this one. Swanee, 3rd and 4. The hit put on Savage, Sammy Davis Jr. Now the spot is important. I think he's a little bit short.
I think he's going to be a little short. And here's a big decision for Bob Stoops. You've got 5 minutes, a little over 5 minutes left.
We welcome those of you that have been watching Penn State and Virginia to Kyle Field in College Station, Texas. As Oklahoma, the number 2 team in the country and the number 1 team in the BCS poll this week, has got their hands full. They're down by 4 to Texas A&M with 5 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the ball game. We've had 3 lead changes in the second half. The story for Texas A&M today in our Pacific Life game summary, it's been the Reggie McNeal show. Reggie comes in, the pump fake and the deep ball. Good for a touchdown to Bethel Johnson. He's hit Terrance Murphy twice on long balls today, a 51 and 40, including one right before halftime that right back in the football game. That one gave them the lead. Oklahoma's battled back, but so have the Aggies. And they now lead 30 to 26. And number 16 has been the star of the show today.
191 yards passing and 90 yards rushing. 4 touchdowns through the air for McNeal.
About the length of the football short is Oklahoma at its own 11 and a half yard line.
What do you do here?
Do you get a chance to even get the ball back if you're Bob Stoops? We know that he's a guy that doesn't mind gambling. This is gambling a season, because if they lose this game, the national championship probably goes by the boards. And they leave the offense in. It's 4th down and less than a yard. The Aggies stop them here, and they might have one of the biggest wins they've had here in a long time.
I cannot think of a worse spot to be in, noise-wise, than down at this closed-in at Kyle Field.
And remember, all day long, for the most part, Oklahoma has gone with a silent count. But this time, Hybl will have to come up under center. 4th down, and about 2 feet. The give, Kewan Jones has got a first down, and he almost broke it. Almost broke it open. That's what he does so well. The redshirt freshman out of Jenks High School in Tulsa. And a big, big play there.
Here it is, right up the middle at you. Great blocking up front.
So a first down and room to work out across the 21. 4:40, clock running. Season on the line for the Sooners, who have two timeouts remaining.
You know, when a head coach does that, it gives confidence to the players. Trust.
Curtis Fagan's been big for Nate Hybl today, but this one's across the middle, complete. Travis Wilson, a freshman who makes the catch, but he's immediately planted by Randall Webb. They only got about 3 yards out of that. Approaching the four-minute mark. Savage, who was shaken up about three plays ago, is back in there. Peoples and Savage to the left. Fagan to the right with Trent Smith, the tight end, slotted that way. Smith, the motion man. High snap, inside handoff to Quentin Griffin. And he didn't get much. Didn't get much. Griffin over 100 yards on the day, but it's been tough sledding. 22 carries to get there.
Griffin, 142 yards.
He's handled it 23 times today, 386 times in a row without putting it on the ground. He doesn't fumble. Third down.
Go down here, you got something down below. Comes a blitz.
Griffin, nope, didn't get it. Now you got to go on fourth down.
Mike Hankwitz, the defensive coordinator, third down. Calling a blitz, he had single coverage. He took a chance that they weren't going to throw. They wanted to stop the run. Here we go again.
Oklahoma today, 1-for-1 on fourth downs. 7 out of 9 on the season. This is a fourth down and a season. 4th and 5. You can barely hear yourself think at Kyle Field. Hybl in the flat. It's deflected. They drop him short of the first down. Ronald Jones with a hit of the day.
They tried a little swing pass to their main man, Griffin. And A&M was all over it. They're in zone coverage. That's just good coverage. Good pants, pass defense.
Threw it out to Ronaldo Works. That was Works out of the backfield. And Jones was all over it.
Oklahoma has two timeouts remaining.
At the 25. A&M in command now. Weber just trying to hold on to it. Got hit at the line of scrimmage. No gain. But the clock stops at 2:18. We got a timeout. Texas A&M leading Oklahoma by 4.
You think you're super bad?
I'm super bad.
For shizzle!
You ain't got no game, brother!
You ain't got no game, brother!
A power so awesome, so irresistible, you'll do anything to get your hands on it. Introducing Gillette M3 Power. Turn on the first battery-powered shaving system from Gillette and turn on the amazing new Power Glide blades. Micropulses raise the hair so you shave closer in one power stroke. Feel the power of the world's best shave. For maximum power, change the battery every 6 months. New M3 Power from Gillette.
For the past 2 years, my mom has been the team mom. She likes to knit. A lot. She watches very closely what we eat.
Boys, what is this?
And of course, she makes sure we eat our Campbell's chunky soup, like new savory beef pot roast.
How about those big chunks of beef and veggies?
Our team's a family, and she's the mom.
Campbell's Chunky. It fills you up right.
Sorry, I was driving too fast.
No, my fault.
You must be gelling.
Like Magellan.
Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are so soft, they make any shoe feel outrageously comfortable. Are you gelling? Dr. Scholl's.
Now through Thursday, Zales is having a store-wide sale with savings throughout the entire store. Like this 5-carat diamond bracelet, just $4.99, our lowest price ever. Quantities are limited. At Zales, the diamond store.
McNeal has been magnificent today. 191 yards passing and 4 touchdowns. And 90 yards on the ground.
Didn't start the game, but certainly is going to finish it.
Boy, is he ever. 218 away from an upset are the Aggies of Texas A&M. Play action. McNeal on a bootleg. He'll keep it. Oklahoma will bring him down. Pasha Jackson makes the stop. You think there aren't a few Longhorns in Austin watching this thing? They would probably be the team that would get the biggest boost out of all of this.
He is outstanding. Been the story, no question. The other time Oklahoma almost got beat this year on the road in Missouri, Brad Smith, redshirt freshman, had a big day running the ball, throwing the ball. Very similar to what McNeal has done here today.
Dino Babers with some final words to him before he'll send him back out. Third down and 9. At the 24-yard line, time running out on the Sooners. They are out of timeouts as well. See if A&M just plays it straight to the middle of the field. They're going to try to throw for it. McNeal, no, he's going to keep it. And he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's
they,
it.
They didn't want to stop the clock. They needed that the clock, those seconds to run off of that clock.
And field goal possibility coming up. And if you do that, you got to watch out for Andre Wolfolk. He's the guy that can get up in the middle and stop the possibility of 3. And you know that's going through the Aggies coaches' minds right now, because we don't even have the field goal unit out there
Stranger
yet.
Stranger things have happened. Exactly. Got to make a decision.
Here comes Reggie McNeal. And he's going to wait until the clock runs down before he tells the referee it's timeout time for Texas A&M. So now they've got all that time to come to the sideline. Think about it, with 1:25 remaining in the ball game. They're going to try a field goal. Todd Pegram, a 43-yarder.
Now they're taking
and they
timeout.
Take another timeout.
Now they are downwind. There's no doubt about that.
Bob and Brad, just so that you know, the timeout was called because they were one player short on the field. And so rather than let the play clock run down and have the ball move back, they use up another timeout.
Todd Pegram, by the way, is the first true freshman ever to be a kicker for R.C. Slocum at Texas A&M. As I said, this time last year, he played soccer in high school. Now, today he's 1 for 1. His career long this season is 43 yards. That's what they've got him lined up for if they choose to kick. But as we said, there aren't too many teams in the country that block kicks better than Oklahoma. And if they do try to kick, the Sooners desperately need one here. And remember, if they do hit the field goal, it's still a touchdown game. And Oklahoma is out of timeouts, but they would still have a crack at it. Remember, Pegram missed an extra point early in the ball game off the right upright. Greg Porter to hold. This is a 43-yarder. And he missed it. He missed it. And Oklahoma's got the chance they needed. 1:19. There's still life in the Sooners. Do they have the Sooner magic? 30-26. And Bob, all Oklahoma wanted was another chance. They'd love to have timeouts, but here's their chance.
Well, in football, timeouts, having no timeouts is not as important if you make a first down, because the clock will stop. If you don't make a first down, the clock will keep running, obviously.
Just outside their own 25. Sooners go to work. Hybl, and whistles blow before that play ever got underway. It's so loud in here that I didn't hear it before the snap, and there you see the delay again.
Now that's a coaching problem on the sideline, because the team came right from the sideline to the line of scrimmage and lined up and played. The official marked the ball ready for play and started the 25-second clock. The team was still on the sideline talking over what they wanted to do.
So now the Sooners are 80 yards away. 1:13 remaining in the ballgame.
And you need a touchdown. Field goals don't help.
Let's see if they're going to reset the clock.
Definitely should reset the clock.
1:19.
So we got to put 6 seconds back on. A loss of 5 yards, but the 6 seconds shouldn't go anywhere,
because there was never a play.
Right. Even though there was a snap, we didn't hear the whistle, and you at home may have been saying, wait a minute, there's a play going on. But that one didn't count. The penalty does.
Oklahoma's got plenty of playmakers. A 22 Griffin catching the ball out of the backfield or running, and all these other receivers had great speed.
Peoples, Savage, and Fagan are the wideouts. Smith the tight end, and Quentin Griffin joining Hybl in the backfield. Hybl to throw on 1st and 15. Deep sideline route. It's intercepted. Terrence Kiel's got it. And the Aggies have got it. They'll win it. The dreams of a national championship might have just gone up in smoke. It'll be only the first loss for Oklahoma. And who knows, maybe the two remaining unbeatens, the two major remaining unbeatens, might fall before it's all over. Who knows? But right now, it's going to be one of the sweetest and biggest upsets ever in the history of Aggie football. 3 losses at home this season, but today they stand up.
He said Kyle Field was a tough place to play, but they had lost 3 times here. Peoples doesn't go up to take the ball away from Kiel, number 48. He should have went up and at least knocked the ball away. He didn't even make a play on the ball.
R.C. Slocum, so many rumors and so many articles, and can he coach anymore? He's been here 14 years, but what have you done for me lately? I'll tell you what he's done for you lately. He's just pulled off a win over the number 2 team in the country.
He had 3 of his defensive starters out of the game. 3 of his offensive starters out of the game.
This might be the best birthday present he's ever had. 58 on Thursday, up by 4 on Saturday. The Aggies win it. There'll be some margaritas consumed in College Station tonight. Two class coaches shake hands at midfield, and Reggie McNeal becomes a cult figure in his first year in the maroon uniform.
He beat the number 1 team in the country.
Quite a core today, on the field and off. Let's go down to Swanee with RC.
Thank you, Brad. Coach, it's got to be a great feeling. Got to be one of the biggest victories for you here at Texas A&M.
Well, it's really fun. We have the guys injured going this game. We stressed all week with the guys. It'd be the guys on the field that were playing that was important, not the ones who were hurt. I'm really proud of our football team. They hung together. We've had some adversity. They never gave up. We got some fighters, some great characters.
Is that the biggest difference in this team, Coach, the way they play? Just the attitude, what they brought to this game?
Well, we've had a bunch of things that's happened to us this year, but I'm really proud of the character of my coaches, my football team, our fans. This is a great setting here today.
Another legend is here on ESPN Classic, 8 p.m. Tuesdays.